the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
What a glorious morning this is for all of us, for the Diocese of Greensburg, for Deacon Carr's family, his friends, for the church, for my brother priests. We welcome a new man to our ranks in a life-changing event, something that will put him on a different path for the rest of his life, for eternity, to be a priest in the line of Melchizedek forever. And we are grateful and we are filled with joy. Welcome to our visitors. Welcome certainly to Deacon Dan Carr's family, soon to be Father Dan Carr, again to his friends and to visitors here among the ranks of priests. Welcome to Bishop Brandt. Bishop, it's good to see you. You began this process with Deacon Dan, so we're grateful that you said yes to allow him to come into our seminary program, which led him to today, to one and all, to men and women religious, to our deacons and their wives. It is good to be together. It is good to be the church called by God to worship Jesus our Lord, who gives each of us a vocation to holiness and then calls within us to do different things on behalf of his body, the church, among them being the priesthood. Brothers and sisters, before we celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind that we are sinners and that we all fall short of God's expectations, and yet God is loving and merciful as we call to mind his great love for us.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring all of us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
God, who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priests, grant a persevering obedience to your will to this deacon of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of priesthood, so that by his ministry and life he may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me thus: Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I know not how to speak. I am too young. But the Lord answered me, Say not, I am too young. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, See, I place my words in your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Every high priest is taken from among men and made their representative before God to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal patiently with the ignorant and erring, for he himself is beset by weakness. And so, for this reason, must make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. In the same way, it was not Christ who glorified himself in becoming high priest, but rather the one who said to him, "You are my son. This day I have begotten you." Just as he says in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." In the days when he was in the flesh, he offered prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverence. Son though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered. And when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Declared by God high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went around to all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom and curing every disease and illness. At the sight of the crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest." The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain Daniel Evans Carr, our brother, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that he has been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose this, our brother, for the order of the priesthood. Thanks be to God.
Father Carr, why did you want to become a priest? Dan, after today, you will get this question on multiple times for the rest of your life. In 2012, when you first asked Bishop Brandt, my predecessor, to accept you as a seminarian for the Diocese of Greensburg, you wrote this: I do not know why I feel called to be a priest. I pushed it aside for such a long time that it feels like a very new thing to me, even though it's not. It's more something that I know and feel inside of me. It's almost as if my head is telling me that this is what will make both me and God happy, and my heart is steadily catching up. I can relate to this. It took me a while to catch up to the call of God, too. After all, a vocation is a mysterious thing, and it takes time to mature until we can embrace it as our own. But when we accept the call of Jesus in our lives, he can do powerful things through us, like consecrate bread and wine, administer the oil of healing, and bring his presence into a world that needs it now more than ever, and by forgiving sins. Like you, every priest eventually realized that the call of Jesus would not leave him alone until he came back with an answer to this question: will you follow me as a priest? Will you follow me as a priest? They all heard it. I heard it. It demands an answer. Some said yes. Some said no. But you are here in this cathedral with all of us to give your answer. Here I am, Lord. Send me. And I hope your knees are knocking a bit. And you have a bottle of aspirin ready. And know that your answer today has eternal significance for you. As Pope St. John Paul II reminded us, like the reading of Hebrews, when a man says yes to the priesthood, that yes is forever. There is no turning back. You have put your hand to the plow. You can only move forward. None of us believes that it will be easy. Priesthood is not easy. Then again, ask your parents if marriage is easy. Is life easy? No vocation comes without the cross, but we glory in the cross, as St. Paul reminds us. Rest assured that the Lord will give you every gift you need to do what he is asking of you. I believe that with all my heart. I know it. I've experienced it. We all have. Who are priests, the Lord will give you everything you need to respond to his call. He will never abandon you. And yet, I need to let you know, and you should not be too alarmed to hear it, but there have been days when I woke up in the morning and asked myself, am I really a priest? Why did I allow this to happen to me? I'm not holy enough, smart enough, good enough. And that's true for all of us who are called Father in the Catholic Church. We're not worthy of our calling. And yet we've been called. We can relate to Peter, who said, depart from me, Lord, for I'm a sinful man. I don't deserve you. And Jesus would never depart from him. God uses the weak to confound the strong. He uses human people like you and me to proclaim that God is better, stronger, and holier than all of us.
yet God still loves us all. God is so other, and yet he comes down to us to speak to our heart and say, I have something I want you to do for me. I told the story before, but I want to tell it again. You'll be hearing it for the next 18 years. And the priest will tell me we've heard this before, but that's okay. A bishop I knew said to a mother, and for those guys from Harrisburg, it was Bishop DiTillo, maybe your son will be a priest someday. And she said to the priest, to the bishop, he's too handsome to be a priest. Then the bishop said to a father, maybe your son will be a priest today. And the man said, my son is too intelligent to be a priest. And the bishop said to someone else, maybe it is your son that Jesus is calling to be a priest. And the parent said, no way, my son is too industrious to be a priest. To which the bishop concluded, all the people want are ugly, stupid, and lazy priests. Will you laugh 18 years from now when I tell that in the next one? But you're none of that. We have come to realize, Dan, that you are very gifted. Your mom thinks you're very handsome. Your university thinks you're very smart. And we know that you are far from lazy. We need more men to answer God's call to be priests. And I challenge all of us in this cathedral to pray for more priests today who will serve our church tomorrow. Ask the Lord of the harvest to send more workers into the field. That's been the perennial call of the gospel. Ask the Lord to send more. We need priests now more than ever. We need priests to stand in his place at the altars of our churches. We need priests who will be tenacious enough to outlast the scandal that has cast a cloud over the honor and dignity of our priesthood. Daniel, we need you to be a priest who is able to live out your celibacy with fidelity. We need you to be a priest who will show us how to live simply in this material world. We need you to be a priest who will celebrate the sacraments with joyful intensity and deep prayer. We need you to be a priest who will preach the word of God with authority in season and out of season, whether it is liked or not. We need you to be a priest who will follow the example of the good shepherd who came not to be served, but to serve, and who came to seek out and save what was lost. We need you to be a priest who is holy, so that by your word and your example, you will build up the house which is our church, God's church. We need you to be a priest who will lead us to a personal encounter with Jesus Christ. It's a lot of demands, but we need you to be that priest. We need all of us to be that priest. I need to be that priest. Now, let me be clear to everyone in this cathedral. All of us, lay people and clergy, together, we are called to bring Jesus into the world. We are all believers, called by Jesus to proclaim the good news. This mission is not reserved to him. It is our mission, not just his or mine or theirs. It's our mission who believe in Jesus to proclaim him to the world. But a priest is a special steward of the mysteries of God. A priest feeds the people of the church with the living Christ so that the people of the church can feed their families and the world with what they have received. Dan, that means that we want you, we need you, we implore you to be a man of prayer. Know Jesus so that you can make him known to us. Know him intimately. Develop your relationship with him. It does not end with priesthood. This is just the beginning. We also want you to be a priest who has the kindness of the stranger who helped the seminarian who fell off his bicycle while riding it on the busy streets of Rome. Inside joke. Be like the Good Samaritan who picked you up when you had fallen. Be like the doctor who set your arm when you had broken it. By the way, those bills are paid, right? Okay. As Pope Francis has said, be like the person in a field hospital who travels to the troubled spots. Don't wait for the patient to come to you. Go to the patient. Be a servant healer, or as Viktor Frankl put it, be a doctor of the soul. There's a lot of broken souls that need some healing. The gift that you will receive today, the gift of the priesthood, is a great gift to you from God. But it is also a gift meant for us. Share your priesthood with us. Refuse to settle for a mediocre priesthood that wants to receive more than it gives. Cardinal Dolan once said this as rector of the North American College where you reside. People want to see their priest. They want to chat with him, shake his hand, get to know him. They expect him to be there at pivotal times such as births, weddings, sickness, trouble, and death. They even expect him to be there at less pivotal times such as meetings, basketball games, bingo, picnics, and socials. They never forget it if you actually visit their homes. Dan, if you live out your priesthood well, it will be the source of great joy for you and for the people who will call you Father. In fact, I cannot wait to experience the joy of concelebrating this Mass with you for the first time as Father Daniel Carr. And every priest in this cathedral is happy to welcome you into the ranks of the priesthood. These are a great group of guys. Folks, these are a great group of guys. Be assured that your son, your brother, your friend, your fellow parishioner is joining a great group of guys. Every priest, every person here is waiting to validate your yes. That leads me to my last bit of advice. Over these last 3 years, I have come to know that you are a pleasant person to be around. Is that right? I think so, right? Okay. He's not been fooling me, has he? No, okay. You have a good sense of humor and a humble way about you. Don't ever lose your ability to smile with others or to laugh at yourself. Share your joy with us. Serve the Lord with gladness. So when you're asked, Father Dan, why did you want to become a priest? After you tell the story of your vocation with all of its twists and turns, remember to say, it makes me very happy to be a priest because this is what God wants of me. This is who God made me to be. And to that, all of us say, Amen. Dear son, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. Do you resolve, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank as a worthy fellow worker with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I do.
Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing?
I do.
Do you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ, the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourself to God for the salvation of all?
I do. The help of God.
Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Please stand.
My dear people, let us pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on this his servant, whom he has chosen for the office of priest.
Let us kneel.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, deliver us, we pray.
Hear us, we beseech you, Lord our God, and pour out on this servant of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that this man, whom in the sight of your mercy we offer to be consecrated, may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us stand.
Draw near, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, author of human dignity. It is you who apportion all graces. Through you, everything progresses. Through you, all things are made to stand firm. To form a priestly people, you appoint ministers of Christ your Son by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose, established through mystical rites, when you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them. You choose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So too in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men, and with their help he ruled your people with greater ease. So also upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's plenty, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles, consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us this helper that we need, to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to this your servant the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within him the spirit of holiness. May he henceforth possess this office, which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. And by the example of his manner of life, may he instill right conduct. May he be a worthy co-worker with our order, so that by his preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may he be a faithful steward of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May he be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to his care and for all the world. And so, may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
O God, who have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labors of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, high priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the Paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself, and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church, Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for this your servant, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of priesthood. And in your mercy, keep safe your gifts in him, so that what he has received by divine commission, he may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took his precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the holy offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
Let us offer one another a sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ, keep me safe for eternal life.
Be afraid, I am with you.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
Monsignor Kulik said this would be over by 12:10. I wanted to prove him wrong. I won the bet. Okay. I want to thank a number of people, obviously. All those who are involved with Father Carr's. Doesn't that sound good, Father Carr? Yes? You're allowed to speak, yes. I want to welcome Father Kurt Belsol, who's here representing the North American College in Rome, where Father Carr still resides. We thank also St. Mark's Seminary in Erie, where he did his pre-theologate. We recognize the role of St. Vincent's College and the role it played in Father Dan's life as well. That's where he got his degree. Was it in computer science, Father? It was, I have an Apple. Do you know how to use apples? Because I control alt thing, I can't get that right. I'll put him to good use. Welcome, I think Brother Norman, the president of the college, is here, and Archabbot Douglas, thank you for being here as well, Archabbot, to represent the Benedictine monks of St. Vincent's, who played that important role in Father Dan's early formation as a disciple of Jesus. Remember, he was a disciple of Jesus and then a priest. We're all disciples of Jesus, and then we get called to those other things like marriage or ordination or diaconate or to the single life. We're called to holiness. I want to thank again Bishop Brandt, who accepted Dan into the seminary program for our diocese. Thank you, Bishop, for your wise decision, and thank you for being here. If you need extra work, I have extra things for you to do. So. Thank you to my brother priests for being here today. You came out in good numbers. I'm so proud of you for doing that. We have a great fraternity, as I mentioned, a great body of priests in our diocese. We're thankful to all of our priests. I want you to give them a word of encouragement today. Please do that. Please thank them for being here. Tyler Bandura, who's the Director of Priestly Vocations. I know that all of our seminarians appreciate your hard work, your kindness, and your advice, and thank you for telling me when to put this thing off and on. I still forget. Thank you to Father Dan's pastor, Father Carr's pastor, Monsignor Ray Riffle, pastor here at the cathedral, and to the cathedral staff for so much work that they do. Thank you for attending this liturgy. You know, I always say liturgy is boring without people. And so thank you for making it exciting, for really participating. Congratulate yourselves for doing a good job. I see our men and women in consecrated life. Thank you guys for being here. And I know that your prayers are so instrumental in the life of our priests and our seminarians. and to the deacons that we have here and the deacons in our formation program and their wives, thanks as well. There are a lot of other people to thank. They're listed on the back of the worship aid. If I missed anyone, I apologize. I'm sorry, but thank you all for what you do. We can highlight, however, our wonderful diocesan choir musicians. You don't just perform, but you worship, and that's a good thing. Thank you, guys. Our servers were wonderful. One was Father Carr's sister, Brienne, WAOB Radio, who's broadcasting this. To our seminarians, could our seminarians stand up or come out or wherever you are? Show yourselves. I think we have five. Pray for them. Pray for them. They have a way to go. And, you know, again, we need priests to serve our church. It's not that the Lord stopped calling priests. I often say this. You're going to hear this a lot. It's that our culture kind of blocks the ears of the men who are receiving the call. So we ask that the Lord take that spiritual earwax out of their ears. And I think sometimes we don't encourage people enough to be priests. And if this is your call from God, this is what you should do. You know, and sometimes we almost discourage people. We know that it's not the a life that people quite understand. But man, if you're called to it, and if you don't do it, what a shame! What a shame! It's a life that would be wasted. So you know, guys, if you're young, if you're well, some of them are older, I guess too. If you hear the call of the Lord to be a priest, you know, investigate it, test it, pray about it. See Father Tyler, our vocations director, or talk to your pastor, talk to someone to figure out what it is that's going on. And if it's of the Lord, don't resist it. Don't say no to the Lord. It never works out well, by the way, when you say no to God. Okay? I want to thank Father Dan's parents. Tom and Linda, stand up, please. Congrats. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Oh, tremendous. Tremendous time. Congratulations. Thank you. You know, most vocations are rooted in the Catholic life of a family. You know, even sometimes you don't know how important that is, but to form them so that they might be open to doing whatever it is the Lord wants them to do. And you did that for Father Carr. You're allowed to call him Dan, however, okay? If you want to call him Father, but Dan's good too, okay? And to his brothers and sisters and to his family, thank you for all you did for him and will continue to do for him. You know, sometimes people say, well, Father, you know, oh, it's so sad you don't have a family. Tell that to my dad. I have a family. I do have a family. So, you know, Father, you're still a member of a family, even though you get a much larger one, too, an extended one. We have to give thanks to God who gives us every good gift, and we thank God for the gift of Father Daniel Carr, and we thank Dan for saying yes to that. Okay. You might want to clap there, too. I have to watch the time so I make sure I win the bet. So now you're wondering, where's Father Dan going to go for the rest of the summer? I'm not giving him off. I've assigned him to be the parochial vicar of the four parishes in Connellsville and Dunbar, Immaculate Conception Parish, St. John Parish, St. Rita Parish, and St. Aloysius Parish. And he will be there as parochial vicar until he returns to Rome at the end of September, I believe, for his final year of studies there. Only one more year, Dan. One more, not two. One. Then you come back and we'll put Father Carr to work. Congratulations, Father Carr, again. Congratulations. Do you feel blessed? Yes. We're blessed. God bless you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of the priesthood. Amen. Amen. May he make you a servant and a witness in the world to divine charity and truth, and a faithful minister of reconciliation.
Amen.
And may he make you a true shepherd to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.